said, "Lo, it is yet high day, neither it is it time that the cattle should be gathered together, water the sheep, and go and feed them." And they said, "We cannot since all the flocks are gathered together until they draw the stone from the well's mouth, then we may water the sheep." And while doing so, speaking with her mouth, came with her father's sheep, for she kept them. They came to catch me, Arpa, son, Rahel, the daughter of Balaam, his father's brother, that she was Balaam, his father's brother. And Arpa went near and rolled the stone from the well's mouth, and watered the father of Balaam, his father's brother. And Arpa kissed Rahel, and raised his voice, and wept. And Arpa told Rahel that he was her father's brother, and that he was her father's son. And she ran and told her father, and it came to pass, and Balaam heard the tidings of Arpa, his sister's son, and he ran to meet him, and embraced him, and kissed him, and brought him to his house, and told Balaam all these things. And Balaam said to him, "Surely thou art my brother, and my flesh, and we stay with him alone." And Balaam said to Arpa, "Because thou art my brother, shouldest thou therefore serve me? For nothing, tell me, what shall thy wages be?" And Laban had two daughters, the name of the elder was Leah, and the name of the younger was Rahel. And Leah's eyes were weak, but Rahel was beautiful in all favor. And Yaakov loved Rahel, and said, "I will serve thee 7 years for Rahel." The younger daughter, Laban, said, "It is better that I serve to thee than that I should give her to another man. Stay with me." Yaakov served 7 years for Rahel, and I seemed to him a few days, for the love he had to her. And Yaakov said to Laban, "Give me my wife, and for my days are fulfilled, that I may go in to her." And Laban gathered together all the men of the place, and made a feast. And it came to pass in the evening, and he took Leah, his wife, his daughter, and brought her to him. And he went in to her. And Laban gave to his daughter Leah, Zilpah, his maid, and made him pass that in the morning. And behold, it was Leah. And he said to Laban, "What is this thou hast done to me? Did not I serve with thee for Rahel? Why then hast thou beyond me?" And Laban said, "It is not to be so in our country to give the younger before the firstborn. Fulfill her wheat, and we will give thee this also for the service which thou shalt serve with me yet another 7 years." And Yaakov did so. Fulfill her wheat, and gave her Rahel his daughter to my wholesome. Laban gave her Rahel his daughter Bilhah, his maid, to her handmaid, and went in also to Rahel. And moreover, he loved Rahel more than Leah, and served with him yet another 7 years. And the Lord saw that Leah conceived, he opened her womb. And Rahel was barren, and Leah conceived, and bore a son, and she called his name Reuben, for she said, "Surely the Lord has looked upon my affliction. Now therefore my husband will love me." And she has conceived again and bore a son, and said, "The Lord has heard that I have this aged. He has therefore given me this son also." And she called his name Shema.